Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 17.4.1 has been out for quite some time at this point, and iOS 17.5 Beta 4 has been out for a few days. But there's even more to talk about since the iOS 17.5 Beta 4 is out What's New video. We'll talk about new features and changes, as well as the overall experience of both 17.4.1 and iOS 17.5 Beta 4. We'll also take a look at your experience based off the YouTube community poll, where at the time of this video, there's over 14,000 votes and 192 comments. I've gone through every single comment to determine what the overall experience is like for most of us, so we'll read some of those toward the end of the video. Now, Apple held their earnings call this past week, and Tim Cook actually had a few things to talk about as far as what to expect with Tuesday's Let Loose event. Tim Cook actually said that Apple is getting ready for an exciting product announcement that they believe customers will love. You can actually listen to the full event here, where they talk about the overall financial results and more. And Tim Cook also confirmed that Apple is or has been making significant investments into AI and has information to share soon. Tim also said, "We'll have an advantage that differentiates Apple from the rest of the competition when it comes to AI." So what that means exactly, we don't really know, but we'll have to wait and see what they have to offer there. However, as far as the AI part goes, we may not hear anything until WWDC. Now, Siri this past week had some issues if you have a HomePod. And with HomePod or HomePod Mini, for many people, it was unable to give you the time and would tell you that it could just send that information to your iPhone. So there's been something going on in the background. Apple has since fixed it, it seems, but maybe Apple's working on AI changes or something in the future that we don't know about. But for whatever reason, it couldn't give you simple tasks or responses to those tasks. Assassin's Creed Mirage is finally coming to iPhone. Apple announced this initially back with the launch of the iPhone. And if we go to the App Store, if you have an iPhone 15 Pro or 15 Pro Max, you can now actually go and pre-order it. So that's something that's available. It's also available on iPad Pro or anything with the M1 chip, the iPad Air, and probably the new iPads coming this coming week. And speaking of iPad, iPadOS sideloading is something that's going to be coming very soon. And the reason for that is Apple actually now has to comply with the laws in the European Union that state that this is now a gatekeeper device, which means Apple has to have the exact same rules with sideloading, third-party app stores, and all of the same rules that apply to iPhone. With that, right after that announcement, Epic Games said they'll be bringing Fortnite to iPad. So that's something we'll probably see in the near future, but just in the European Union. At this point, I really wish Apple would just allow everyone to use these sideloaded developer apps or third-party app stores, and that's something we're just not seeing just yet. But maybe in the near future, they'll finally allow us to, but so far they're only doing it to comply in the EU. Apple has also made it very difficult for apps to make a profit if they do determine to use that third-party app store. In fact, up until recently, it was very tough for anyone to make a profit if their app was going to go viral. Apple has since changed some of the core technology fee structures to help out with this. So they updated this webpage, I can link it in the description, but it explains how the overall fee works for developers if they're using it with a first annual install, and you'll see 1 million free first annual installs. So there's all of these different rules that make it a little bit easier on the developer if they're going to be selling an app outside of the App Store. So it's good to see this change, and it really helps out developers that way. Now, Apple's Let Loose event is actually on Tuesday, and I wanted to mention a couple things about it because we're all waiting for it. And if we scroll down on the Apple website, Apple has been promoting this quite a bit, and we're expecting iPads. You'll see the Apple Pencil twirling there. We're expecting a new Apple Pencil, iPad Air, iPad Pro models, and maybe a few surprises. However, some things we won't be seeing is new iPad minis, a regular iPad, Macs, or even AirPods, according to all of the latest leaks. So it's just going to be basically an iPad event, maybe with some other announcements also. And if you wanted to watch the event, we'll all be watching this pretty much at the same time on Tuesday at 7 a.m. Pacific time or 10 a.m. Eastern time. And you can add it to your calendar and just have it remind you. So that will be going on this Tuesday. And of course, as soon as I know more information as what they're releasing, we'll talk about that maybe in a separate video. As far as new features this week, well, Apple has added new cycling directions in Maps. And if you're in the Netherlands, you now have cycling directions that will give things such as elevations. You can see the bike route and main roads and may require some walking. So those are now available in the Netherlands. That's something that wasn't there before that they've finally added. And you'd think they would have added this quite some time ago, as many people bike in Netherlands. So that's something that I'm surprised we haven't seen so far. Another feature that's typically there for some people is not working properly for some in Germany. I've heard in the Netherlands that the news app widget is just sort of disappearing. It's not working properly outside the United States, and apparently Apple's investigating this. So if you've been having those issues, typically in Europe, it seems that it's a problem. Apple's aware of it, and hopefully it'll be fixed soon if it isn't already by the time you're watching this video. Now in the iOS 17.5 beta 4 is out what's new video, I talked about a repair mode that was in the code. You can actually find this where you can see it within Find My. So I talked about it, couldn't find it earlier, but since it's been located. So we'll go into Find My. Under devices, if we go to remove a device, tap remove, you'll see we get a new pop-up that says cannot remove iPhone. Prepare this device for repair. This iPhone is linked to your Apple ID and cannot be removed while it's online, but you can still prepare it for repair. Tap continue. You can see here that now it's in repair mode. We have a little icon and it moved down below. However, there's no easy way to take it out of repair mode. So you'll see it says remove iPhone. You can remove it, but there's not an easy way to remove it from repair mode altogether. So maybe Apple forgot that part of it, or they need to fix it in the future, but that's a new feature in beta 4. With iOS 17.5, well, so far we know everything in it as it seems to be mostly complete, or this is the final version. So it's basically the finale of betas, and then we move on to the final release candidate and then the public release. So iOS 17.5 so far has EU sideloading via the web, has some updates with Game Center in the news. It also has a news game called Quartiles. There's been updates in the Books app for a new activity or reading goals sort of activity monitor there, just like we have with workouts in the upper right. We also have the podcast widget that changes based on what podcast we're playing. So if we go in here and maybe turn down the volume, we'll go ahead and play the Waveform podcast. It will change to match the actual podcast itself. Also, there's changes to privacy and setting, there's updates in emoji, and there's also new spotlight search that goes along with podcasts as well, where it recommends the latest podcasts you've been listening to. So lots of different changes. There's even more. We still have not seen stopwatch live activities been replaced here. So if we go into the stopwatch, hit start and swipe home, it doesn't go into the live activity in the dynamic island. It still works for timers, just not that one in particular with the stopwatch. So maybe Apple's waiting until iOS 18 for that. And also we don't have SharePlay to HomePod and Apple TV in this update, like we did with 17.4 betas. iOS 18 leaks continue to flow out at a steady pace as we're approaching WWDC 2024. Apple Insider this time has said that the calendar app on the iPhone will integrate directly with reminders this time around. So if you're using the calendar, you'll be able to go into the calendar and then set a reminder and reorganize your reminders. They're also said to have a similar functionality on macOS 15 to go along with that, where they'll sort of match what they're doing here. Many apps are also expected to get an update in iOS 18, such as Maps, Apple Music, Calculator, Calendar, Fitness, Freeform, Health, Mail, Messages, Notes, Photos, Safari, and Shortcuts. Even the iWork apps, such as Pages, Numbers, and Keynote, are said to get updates also. So all of those things are said to be coming with iOS 18, and we should see huge updates with that. Not a full redesign, according to Mark Gurman, but we will have a lot of different app updates. We're expecting this to be a major update, so hopefully we'll get some different changes, such as the control center, and maybe some other functionalities, such as split view. We don't really know yet, but that's what we'll have to wait and see. Apple releases this week were what we expected. We had iOS 17.5 beta 4 and all of the different betas to go along with that, with watchOS, iPadOS, and even visionOS. However, we got one unexpected update, and that has to do with Apple Pencil. Now, not this Apple Pencil, this is the second generation, but the new USB-C Apple Pencil was updated to a new firmware version. We don't know specifically what it does. Maybe it adds compatibility with the latest iPads that are said to come out next week, but it bumped it up to version 10M5164 with a very long firmware number I'll place here. So this has been updated. So if you have a USB-C Apple Pencil, one of the latest ones, just leave it plugged onto your device and it should update on its own. There's no specific way to update it. Now this week we heard a lot about alarms not working on the iPhone. I've talked about this at length with previous iOS updates, and now it seems to be a problem for more and more people. Apple actually confirmed there's an issue with the alarm not sounding for some. So if you've used the alarm and the clock app, this could be a huge problem. And thankfully, it hasn't been an issue for me lately, but for some people, it's definitely an issue on iOS 17.4.1. Apple confirmed it this week with the Wall Street Journal that a fix is coming in an update soon. Now, whether or not that's iOS 17.5 or something else, we don't know for sure, but maybe we'll get an iOS 17.4.2 release this coming week. Since iOS 17.5 is expected soon, we could have a release maybe as soon as Monday or Tuesday with that sort of public release. Then I would expect iOS 17.5 RC or release candidate after the Apple Let Loose event on Tuesday. That's typically what Apple does. The release candidate is the final version released to developers and public beta testers, which usually is the same as the final version released to the public if there's no additional issues. Then after that, we could have a final release probably on the 13th. Typically after an event, the following Monday we'll have that if the new iPads are coming on the 17th. However, we could see it release earlier than that. Apple hasn't said specifically. When it comes to iOS 18 Beta 1, that's where all of the major features are expected to be shown on June 10th after WWDC's first keynote. That's what we typically get, and then we'll have it released to developers so we can check it out ourselves and see all of the new features. So I would expect that on June 10th, usually around 3 or 4 p.m. Eastern time, and then we can try that out and see what's new. When it comes to the overall iOS 17.5 experience, well, it seems to be pretty good overall, but there's still some issues here and there. It seems to be smoother this time with less stutters, including on older devices, according to many of you. So just scrolling through, maybe opening weather, give it a second to load. It's nice and fast. You'll see there were a few stutters there, but less than what we had before. If we go over to ProMotion here, it's nice and smooth on the 15 Pro Max. And it's what you would expect on the iPhone 11. Just things in general seem to be nice and fast, no issues, everything's loading quickly, and it's a decent experience that way. There's been no lockups for me this time around, and I personally haven't had overheat issues. We'll talk about that in a moment, as some of you have. But as far as bugs go, AirDrop is really slow this time around for me. I'm not sure why, but if we go into Photos and maybe try and AirDrop this, we'll AirDrop this over to let's say the 15 Pro Max over here. And now, of course, it's fast. But sometimes I'll send maybe a photo, such as this wallpaper, and it's super slow. Last time it sort of locked up and I had to send it again. But you'll see it's stuck there in the top, even though it sent. So there's definitely some issues here and there where it's sort of stuck, even though it sent over there. And that's what I'm seeing with this beta for some reason. Also, standby mode is still a problem. I'll bring in this anchor stand here and I'll place my phone on it. Then we'll lock it and have it go into standby mode. Give it a second, and now we're in standby. The problem is we can't edit this. Once you've edited it once, you cannot go back and edit it, no matter what clock screen you're on. So for whatever reason, it doesn't seem to work, and this is definitely a bug that everyone seems to be experiencing, all the way from iOS 17.4.1 through the 17.5 betas. Also, notifications this time are still squared off, but not as severely as before. So if we go in, pull down notifications, sometimes they're squared off, sometimes they're not. It really is back and forth, and we don't know why. iOS 17.4.1 still has the regular bugs to expect, such as micro stuttering, issues with battery for many people, keyboard lag, AirPods connectivity for some, and some still have the volume bug, where it just sort of jumps all over the place. And that hasn't happened to me, thankfully, in 17.5, but I know a lot of people are experiencing those bugs, along with the iOS 17.4.1 clock bug, so where the alarm doesn't work. So that's a major issue. Overall connectivity is okay when I'm on Wi-Fi, but with 5G, it's been really hit or miss this time around. Even though we didn't have a different modem number, something was going on where maybe I'd have low signal or a couple bars. I'd go into Safari, try and load something. It just wouldn't load. I'd have to actually turn on airplane mode, turn it back off, and then it would reconnect and work properly. I'm not sure what's going on with it, but it was definitely an issue, and I know there were no issues with my carrier, at least in the past week or so. As far as the camera goes, well, let's take a look at some of the photos. I took some videos and photos, as you can see here, and I think they look pretty good. I have no complaints with it. It seems to be what you would expect, and I've been pretty impressed with it. I don't think they made any changes here, but let me know your experience with the camera in the comments below. Now, when it comes to the overall heat of the device, well, mine has actually been pretty good, but I've seen quite a few complaints that it's been overly hot just using it, or especially when it's charging. Now, Apple may allow faster charge rates if it's within the overall thermal limits, but we don't really know as they don't tell us in the notes, but it seems to be fine for me. I haven't noticed any differences, but let me show you on the thermal camera. On iOS 17.5 beta 4, at the hottest point, we're at about 89 to 90 degrees Fahrenheit. On 17.4.1, while it's not in use, we're at about 85 to 86 degrees Fahrenheit. And in Celsius, we're at about 33.1 degrees Celsius, and on 17.4.1, about 30.3 degrees Celsius. I ran Geekbench right before recording this video, and we scored 2,941 for single core, 7,302 for multi-core. If we take a look at previous weeks or the previous times I've run them, it seems to be a lot better for multi-core this time around, and even faster than the previous couple of times or few times with single core. So overall, it's nice and fast and smooth, like most people are saying. Battery life is another concern though. If we go into settings, we'll go down to battery health. You'll see I have 98% and I'm at 175 cycles. So overall, it's pretty good for me. I know some people have 100% still, some people are lower, but it doesn't seem to matter how you charge it or anything else. Some people actually try and monitor it and only charge 20 to 80% and are still at about 96%. It doesn't seem to really make sense what's going on, but it is dropping rapidly for some people. It's not the beta. Phones are basically using the battery more, and it's actually degrading the battery health faster since you have to cycle the battery more and more. Battery life overall hasn't been great for me either. I had 3 hours and 10 minutes of screen active time today, 3 hours and 44 minutes of screen idle time, and used about 75% of my battery. But it's been plugged in since and I'm at 44%. So it's not great. You'll see here if we go back to the last 24 hours where it was charged, and today it was charged and then discharged and then used a little bit last night, and I'm not getting great screen on time at all. Maybe by the time I go to bed, I'll have to charge it once or I'll have 20 or 30%. Some people say it's really good. For me, it just hasn't been. And if you're wondering if you should install iOS 17.5 beta 4, if you're on beta 3 or any of the prior betas, definitely install this version as we need to test and then give more results to Apple through the feedback app. However, if you're on iOS 17.4.1, I would wait for 17.4.2 maybe this week, or possibly 17.5 in about a week or so. So at this point, I think we really should wait a little bit and see if they fix more issues. I wouldn't update to 17.5 just to try and resolve issues since it's still in beta. Now let's go ahead and see what you had to say in some of your comments. Quad Rider Honda said, using 17.5 beta 4, Apple Music and cellular connectivity has been buggy for me since beta 3 and still continues with beta 4. Other than that, it's been pretty great. Great battery and performance. By the way, I'm using a 15 Pro Max. Gary Holbrook said, iPhone 15 Pro Max, battery life is markedly improved. Also noticed beta 4 improved life on my Apple Watch Ultra 2 by leaps and bounds. Beta 3 was draining it like crazy. Cloud W3158 said, I'm on iOS 17.5 beta 4 on my iPhone 14. The performance is great and battery life is amazing. Yesterday I had 7 hours of screen on time with still 25% left of the battery. Magnificent Production said, hey Aaron, I'm on iOS 17.5 beta 4 on my 14 Pro Max. The battery life is better than on iOS 17.5 beta 3. However, this update is loaded with bugs. Hopefully we see improvements as we head towards iOS 18. Jesse Jones, NV3VD, says beta 4 is faster than beta 3, but there is still problems with YouTube and horrible battery life to the point where I have to charge it every day. Self-Made Documentary says, I'm on 17.4.1 and this is the first time I've had bad battery issues. Charge doesn't hold up for a day and I've not changed my habits. iPhone 14 Pro just over 1 year old and already at 88% battery health overall. So that's everything with iOS 17.5 beta 4. If you found any other features, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below, and hopefully we'll have a new update soon for 17.4.1. Now, of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.